8 seconds. That's how long an average adult can concentrate on a subject. If it takes longer than that, you risk losing people's attention. Now, this rule applies to user onboarding as well. You have to show new users the product's value quickly or risk losing their attention entirely. And in this video, I'm gonna share with you 8 proven user onboarding strategies to help users find your product's most critical value events without slowing them down. Hey friends, it's Ramley John from AppQs. If you want to get the best user onboarding tips and tricks, be sure to smash that subscribe button. Anyway, let's jump in to share with you 8 user onboarding strategies to boost your retention. First is to start simple. Introduce concepts and vocabulary that might be new to your users and explain how they bring value to their business. For instance, in AppQs, we have a simple flow to educate users about different onboarding UI patterns like modals, tooltips, and hotspots. Second is to show and tell. Get users to learn by doing and using interactive guides that prompts users to click key areas in your UI. Video is also a very powerful medium, especially for complex products that require a little more explanation. That's exactly what Deputy, an employee scheduling tool, does. They show a personal video from the CEO who walks new users through the product. 3 is to personalize the experience. Now, more complex products often have a few different use cases. Each of these use cases matches a different user persona. By personalizing the user onboarding experience, you can help users see and experience the product's value quicker than before. An example of a product that tailors the experience for different use cases is Canva. They ask their users what their goal is with Canva, which they suggest relevant templates based on that response. As you can see, personalizing the experience based on your user's goals will help you guide them to achieve their first quick win even faster. 4 is be contextual. Consider what your users might have already done in your website or your product and what expectations or prior knowledge they might have already. For example, Duolingo asks how proficient new users are with the language they're trying to learn. It's particularly helpful for intermediate and advanced users so they don't get bored going through the basics again. If you've got a handful of users starting from scratch and others who have used similar tools before, it might be worth segmenting your user onboarding experience based on the knowledge or skill level of new user. 5 is nudge users to come back. Now, it's short-sighted to assume that your user onboarding experience will be enough to convince users to come back to your app or to teach them everything they need to know in one sitting. Now, think about the first experience to a user's second visit and beyond. What can you do to support the people who have finished your onboarding experience? For instance, Slack gives users a magic link to log into different workspaces that they haven't visited in a while, so they don't struggle to remember yet another password. Your returning newcomer will also appreciate it if they can find your onboarding resources in an easy to find, predictable location within your UI menu or settings. 6 is to provide a compelling quick win. Another proven user onboarding strategy is to provide a quick win as soon as possible in the onboarding experience. An example of this is Twitter. Whether or not a user follows other people on Twitter is an important retention indicator for the product. So Twitter encourages new signups to follow at least 20 other users within a single click to make sure you get the most out of the product. And users are also shown a checklist of topics to choose from with some popular accounts already selected. 7 is to trigger tutorials based on user actions. If your application relies on new concepts without established patterns of behavior, make sure new users don't leave until they understand it and have shown that they want to do it themselves. For instance, it would have been easy for Pinterest to force users to click through a step-by-step tutorial on creating the first pin right at the signup. But before Pinterest came along, concepts like digital pins and boards weren't that well known. So Pinterest doesn't trigger its tutorial immediately. It lets users explore at their own pace and wait until they click on an image feed to make sure to show a tutorial. 8 is onboard teams and not just a single user. The way software is being bought is changing and the buyer for a company often starts as an individual user. Collaborative team-based SaaS products like Slack know the sooner they can connect these individual users to a team, the more momentum they build toward a premium upgrade. Now, Slack built its teammate invitation right into the onboarding flow prior to letting you use your product. Since teammates are what really makes Slack valuable, with a simple opt-in, the app allows new users to let their teammates join. This all happens without additional permissions being requested, as long as the employee created an account using a verified company email address. Making these connections between users and team can really help a whole company get onboarded to your product in record time. To wrap it up, a great onboarding experience boils down to your ability to connect the initial steps you're asking users with the value your product brings. The quicker you can guide them to their relevant aha moment in your product using time-tested education techniques, the better. Well, that's all for now. If you found this video valuable, share it with your colleagues and friends. We've also created a free user onboarding certification course that details how to create an onboarding experience that turns more of your users into paying customers. We got the link below in the description. Make sure to check it out. Don't forget to also subscribe to get the best tips and tricks to improve your product's user onboarding. That's all for now. Check out our other videos. This is Ramley John from AppQs. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.